Hello and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, we're going to try and learn how to create this particular thing with text in few easy steps. So let's just get started. Let's just create a new file. Go to File and New. I'll make this 9 into 9 inches. CMYK and 150 PPI. Click Create. The first step is to create text. I'm just going to click on my text tool and type the three texts that I want to use. So it's Y. Let me just increase the size. I have used Ariel Black. And let me put this at 300. I'm just going to create one more. Click on your optional Alt key, click and drag. Double click and let's type this as N. And let me just create one more which says so and pull it up a little bit and let's make this 400. Let's put it somewhere in the center and the next one click outside somewhere and let's make it no in caps and this should be 300. Okay, I'll drag it and pull it over here. And I'll give it different colors so it'll be easy to recognize them. So it's pretty easy to recognize. I'll just increase the size of the artboard a bit. Okay, now this is perfect. Okay, let's bring this up a little this side. And no goes a little down. There's a bit of an overlap between S and O, like this. Let me bring the Y and N to the front. Shift, Command, Close Square Bracket. So everything looks good. Now it's time for the next step. I'm just going to my rectangle tool. If you cannot find it, right click and rectangle tool. And then click and drag to make a rectangle which fits your artboard. I'm really going to send it to back by Command Shift and open square bracket. And this one, we're going to color something which is very light. I will leave all the color codes below so you can use them later. These colors that we have given right now is temporary, just so that we can notice the difference between different words. All right, so once this is done, now it's time to cut them up into pieces. But before doing that, just select all your alphabets that you have and right click, create outlines. And now it's all ready to be split up into pieces. So let's go to our line segment tool. And here, just switch it up so that your stroke has a color. And let's make this as white. Now, let's draw some random straight lines, depending on how you want to cut them. So, and make sure the straight lines are not close to each other, because we want bigger chunks. And that will make it look nicer. And they should not be uniform as well, because if they're uniform, they won't come out that good. And it's not necessary that they should be parallel to each other. Just randomly draw some straight lines. I think like these are like way too spread out. So I'm just gonna add some more here. And here, and maybe one. Here, I think this is all enough. We can check that later. So click and select everything. And now we're going to go ahead and divide this. Go to your Pathfinder tool. If you cannot find it, go to Window and then Pathfinder. In here, click on Divide. Now everything is divided into tiny pieces, but they're all held together with the group function. So we're going to ungroup that. Command or Control, Shift, and G, and this ungroups it. So if you click on it, it's a separate piece. So now we're going to color this. To color this, go to your swatches. If you cannot find swatches, it's in Window and then swatches, and go to your library. Again, it's in Window and library, and here select the theme that you want. For example, I'm just going to go to my library here and select a theme. I'm just going to select a theme here, right click, add theme to swatches. And it appears over here. So you can add more than one theme here. You can use as many colors as you want, but I'm going to keep this very simple and use just 5 colors. So if you want to add more colors, you can get them from your library, or you can individually add them. To get them from your library, I have a separate video up there which will show you how to do that, and you can go check it out. I'll leave it in the description box below or add it as a card in this video. Okay, so once this is selected, now let's go ahead, click and select everything. So all these things are selected. Now I'm going to go ahead and click on this and hold your shift key down and click on the last color so that all the colors are selected. And we're going to use a script to apply color. You can individually go and apply color to each boxes here, but I think it's better if we use a script, especially when we have a much bigger piece of artwork. It's better to use scripts. If you don't know how to use scripts, don't worry. I have a video already. I will link it down below in the description. So I'll just go to File, Scripts and Other Scripts and pick up my script that is Randomizer. I'll just double click and it automatically assigns some colors. If I'm not happy with that, I'll just go back again, Scripts, and do it again and it'll assign some more colors. So let me just do it one more time. Okay. All right, so we have some colors assigned, but this is not the final thing. So click outside. So now, as you can see, there is a red outline on all of this. So I'm just going to select and select everything and click on none for stroke. Now it looks better, but we have some things extra. So just click on this, click on delete on your keyboard, and let's do that. All right, so that's all right, but you can see that the alphabets have disappeared. So now our task is to bring them back out. So I'm just gonna click on this. And if we change this color to something which is non-white, then your alphabet automatically appears. So click on this, please. Click on I for the eyedropper tool, or you can click them here. And I'll eyedrop this red color over here. And I can see there's a small portion here as well. So I'm just going to make it blue so that it's evident as well. That looks fine. All right, so let's move on to next alphabet. How about this one? For example, this and this is both yellow, so it's just disappearing. So I'll just click on this and I'll have to give it some color. I could give it any color. I'll just give this color over here. And now you can see that it's completely different. So let's do something for this one here. Let's give it white. Now you can see the alphabet O, which is clearly formed. So there's a bit of a problem here. So I'm just going to click on this one right here and make it white. Let's do the same for this S, especially this part. So click on this and let's give this white. And let's click on this and make this red. So let's do something very similar over here. If you click on this, instead of blue, I'll give it yellow, and then automatically you can see the N pop out. So it's the same here. I'm just going to make this white. So this looks pretty okay, but there's a slight bit of problem here because this is too much yellow in here. So I'll just click on blue and make this blue. And this tiny bit over here, let's make this white just to make it a little different. I know what you're thinking. We recolored a lot of things, but it's very nice to start with the script and then color it as and when you want, like however you want. A basic idea about having an alphabet mix and matching it with different colors is ready. For example, here, since I use the script, it's completely different here. There's more white in here, but in here, there's more, it's more colorful and eye-popping. So there's so many different ways in which you can arrange the color to make sure that it matches what you have in your mind. For example, this is like so muted and so white. It's like really simple and looks like minimalistic. Whereas this one is so bright and colorful and cheerful, and it's the opposite of that one. Okay, so this is how you create this particular type of type. And I hope you liked this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up and hit subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.